Alright, this is just a drill for you to kick back for your keepers. As you talked about there, kicking is probably the most important one in the other game. Alright, that's a brilliant drill to get them a wee bit more conditioning when they're doing it, because they're going to get tired as the game goes on and their kick needs to be the same. Alright, so that's a great drill to get that up and going. I would have met Gary Matthews before. Gary, if any of you know Gary Matthews, he was the goalkeeping coach of Dublin. He would have worked with Stephen Clarkson and on the kickouts. And we all talk about Stephen Clarkson, who revolutionised the game, which he did, alright, but he obviously had to be instructed to do so. He was instructed by Pat Gilroy. He said that we wanted the kickouts gone inside 7 seconds. Alright, so he's obviously taught that, but he didn't just magically start hitting pockets because Pat Gilroy told him to do it. He was coached it. Alright, and little drills like that there, alright, being taught at training, kick the balls out inside 7 seconds, that needs to be implemented into your training sessions. You can't just go and tell your goalkeeper, right, I want to gain possession from every kick out and let the keeper do it himself. He has to be coached to do it through games, through conditioned games you do with your outfielders. Alright, your keeper's not going to get good at kick outs to his defenders if they haven't got a kick out from him. Alright, so implement your goalkeeper as much as you can into your trainings. Don't just leave them over there at the side to work themselves. Take them into your drills, take them into your any games you can, and incorporate the kick out as much as possible. Because why? We do 25 to 30 kickouts a game. Why are we not working on them at training? Alright, we talk about shooting, we talk about kicking the ball into your forwards. That's important too. But the kickouts is just as important, because we do it 20 to 25 times a game on average. Alright, so we need to work at that in our training test.
Hands up, honestly, if you're a manager of a club and you actually work on the kickouts, man for man, you work on the most high, volatile, pressured side of the game. The players have to move to get the ball, spin people away. Whether it's the halfbacks, wherever moving the midfielders, to make space for someone else to get the ball.